Let's talk about creating a new sequence in a basic edit. As you may recall in an earlier lesson, I recommend creating a few empty bins ahead of time for every project. Most importantly, I recommend that you create a sequence bin where you will store your sequences in order to stay organized. To get started, I'm going to select all these bins and right-click on them and choose Open Selected Bins in one window. Now, I've already organized my content into the various bins. And remember, each bin has three different displays, and this bin is set to Frame View. Click on the Sequences Bin tab and right-click within the gray area of the bin. Choose New Sequence. Give the sequence a name. So in this case, I'll call it Sports Montage. In the Timeline window, you should now see a video track along with two audio tracks. In Avid, you will see the current sequence you are working on in two distinct areas. Look at the top of the Timeline window and in the upper right corner of the Composer window. Verify that this matches the sequence you are working on. If it says Untitled Sequence, you should immediately stop, find your sequence, and give your sequence a proper name. Okay, so after you've created a sequence, go back to your video bin and load a clip into the source window. In doing so, you will see some new tracks appear to the left of your sequence tracks. The important concept here is whatever is loaded into this source window will be displayed as tracks on the left side of the timeline window. So this indicates that this clip here has both audio and video content. Some clips may not have any sound, so if I drag this stock footage clip of fire into the source window, you will see that the clip only contains video content. Or I've got my audio bin here, and if I drag an audio clip into the source window, you will see it has two channels of audio, but no video content. Each time you load a different clip into the source window, the Avid keeps a recent clip list in the upper left corner. So instead of clicking back into the video bin, you can reselect your video clip without having to go back and find it. Okay, depending on the type of clip that you have loaded into the source window, you will have a separate video monitoring icon along with a solo and mute button. If you turn off this monitor icon, the video display for your clip will turn black. Under normal circumstances, you will almost always want to leave this monitor icon enabled for each individual clip. And if you click on this mute button, you will not hear the sound. Now, there are two main methods of editing a clip to a sequence. You can either drag a clip directly to the timeline window, or you can use one of these two buttons. Before you make your first edit, you will notice the individual tracks for a source clip can be turned on or off. This tells the Avid what you are editing to the timeline and where it is going. To demonstrate, if I drag a clip from the source window into the timeline with the video and audio tracks turned on, you will get both the video and audio content in the sequence. Now, I'll undo that operation, and I will turn off the audio track. This time, notice that you only get video content. Okay, again, I'll undo. And if you turn off the video track, this time you will only get the audio content. And of course, if both tracks are off, nothing will happen. Alright, let me turn the source tracks back on and mention one more thing. Instead of dragging and dropping a clip to the timeline window, I recommend that you use one of these two editing buttons. These buttons will accomplish the same task of editing a clip to the timeline, but they will save you the strain of constantly having to use the mouse when dragging clips. Now, don't worry, we'll cover the fundamentals of these two editing functions in an upcoming lesson, but for now, you should have the basics of creating a sequence and editing a clip to the timeline.